The world of freight transport is changing fast, but many experts are skeptical of whether electric medium and heavy duty trucks can compete with traditional internal combustion engine trucks, especially diesel. In this video, we look at Tesla's semi-truck and a new milestone it recently accomplished. As part of an 18-day run on less program by the North American Council for Freight Efficiency, NACFE, which was held from mid to late September, Semi managed to travel a distance of nearly 1,100 miles in just 24 hours. That accomplishment may potentially shift the narrative about electric trucks and their capabilities. Hello everyone, my name is Mark Weich. Thanks for checking out this video on cleanearth.io. Before I continue, if you haven't already, please hit that like and subscribe button. By doing that, you're really helping us to grow our platform as well as improve what we do here, and we simply appreciate it. This milestone is noteworthy for several reasons, and one is the efficiency of Tesla Semi. Tesla claims that Semi uses less than 2 kilowatt hours per mile. Now, by comparison, the average EV passenger car uses about 3 kilowatt hours per mile. So this milestone makes Tesla Semi a legitimate contender in the freight industry. So if you're still not convinced by the milestone by Tesla Semi, three of the Tesla Semis participating in the trial logged just over 19,000 miles in 2 weeks. 65% of those miles traveled were with loads exceeding 70,000 pounds. Now, on US roads, the maximum that a commercial vehicle can carry is 80,000 pounds. So this is very much representative of what a Class 8 semi can carry under US regulations. So I'd like to hear what you think about that milestone. In preparation for the Tesla Semi's missions, four 750 kilowatt Tesla chargers were installed with a combined 3 megawatts of installed charging capacity at PepsiCo's Sacramento, California facility. The chargers are also supplemented with Tesla Megapack battery energy storage solutions. PepsiCo worked with utility provider Sacramento Municipal Utility to ensure the 24-hour-a-day fleet's operational needs could be met. PepsiCo is among Tesla's major customers for Semi, incorporating 21 Class 8 Semi trucks into their Sacramento-based fleet. Since PepsiCo's initial acquisition of Semi in December 2022, the Class 8 trucks have covered close to 680,000 zero-emission miles as of September 1st, 2023. PepsiCo's Tesla Semi fleet operate in two primary types of missions. They either run long-haul missions between 250 and 520 miles, or have 18 distinct delivery missions covering less than 75 miles daily. Amanda DeVoe, PepsiCo's fleet transformation strategy director, said Semi was perfect for the company's deliveries of under 100 miles across 1,200 days. She added that the Tesla Class 8 is the most advantageous in the company's decarbonization strategy and falls in line with the company's broader Pepsi positive ambition of achieving net zero emissions by 2040. Frito-Lay, a PepsiCo subsidiary, also participated in the Run on Less event. Their North America operations in Queens, New York, is undergoing one of the fastest and largest fleet and charging transformations in the company. By the end of this year, 2023, the company plans to bring into its fleet 60 Ford E-Transit electric vans. Following the event, Frito-Lay will provide learnings and data from two of the Ford E-Transits that participated in the event with the focus on optimizing urban mobility. So why does this all matter? Well, commercial vehicles, especially heavy-duty class vehicles and last-mile delivery vehicles, contribute heavily to tailpipe pollution. Tesla Semi and other electrified freight solutions are essential to curbing this problem, especially for many large corporations, as logistics and freight form the backbone of their business operations. This year's NACFE Run on Less program is focused on sharing learnings from industry leaders to scale electric trucks across a variety of market segments, helping to showcase what it takes to scale a fleet of electric vehicles, including building a charging network and its supporting infrastructure, along with building grid capabilities and energy resilience. The findings from the NACFE Run on Less event are really designed to help corporations build out their electrification plans, as well as adopt new technology and manage collaborations with local electric utilities to ensure the necessary power capacity and other capabilities for electrification are in place, and also help companies effectively expand their depots to support electric vehicles. The Run on Less event featured 10 fleet depots that operate 15 or more Class 3 to Class 8 battery electric vehicles in the US, Canada, or Mexico. So, do you think this kind of infrastructure can be replicated easily in other parts of the country or in your part of the world? Also, how do you feel about Tesla Semi's performance during the Run on Less program? Is this milestone by Tesla Semi noteworthy? And also, what are your thoughts on businesses adopting electric trucks like Tesla Semi for medium and long haul applications? We'd love to hear your thoughts. So be sure to leave your thoughts and your questions in the comment section below. Thanks for checking out this video. And as always, be sure to hit that like and subscribe button. We'll see you in the next video soon. Thanks.